Hi guys, welcome to my video. Today I will be painting with Rebelle. I'll go over some of my tips and tricks I use to get beautifully textured paintings using the watercolors, express oils, and Impasto brushes. Hopefully you'll find this video helpful and informative. Let's begin. I first begin with a 13 by 19 inch 150 DPI canvas. This is to ensure that my computer does not lag. There's a variety of canvases to choose from on the Rebelle website. Here I have quite a few. I personally like the textured ones. The more textured, the better for the final outcome. And here we can take a look at a few of them. Each one of them is different and affects the way the paint interacts with the canvas, which will again affect the overall finished piece. Next, let's look at visual settings. The tab has quite a few different presets. I suggest going through all of them and playing with them, see what you like. You can adjust any one of them with the sliders. Once you have something that you like, you can also save that as a custom. Next, we'll start applying the watercolors. I tend to pick brushes that are very rough and scrappy looking. More texture, the better. The little eye here will actually allow for you to see what is currently wet on your canvas. I grab a sponge brush, and with different brushes, I randomly dry areas. This will lend to the overall textures. I do this over and over. Eventually, I will dry the canvas and begin again. Different brush tips will give you different textured results. Make sure to dry your canvas often. There's a variety of free brushes available on Rebelle's website. I use the eraser pretty often for a few reasons. It clears up some of the paint and it allows for a fresh area for new paint to be applied if the canvas is oversaturated. Any brush can be used as an eraser and each will lend you different textures. And here I'm able to add more color into the areas I just cleared off. Thank you. you find that the canvas is no longer accepting more ink, you can add another layer. This will allow you to put more paint on top. Usually I'll dry the layer and then merge down to one again. I like to use the smudge brush pretty often to blend out hard areas and smooth certain things. You can always re-go back over. Adding a layer on top allows for the paint to run without mixing with the below layer. One of the things I love so much about Rebelle is being able to use watercolors, oils, and acrylic paints and mixing them all. Using the visual settings, you can change the paper texture, the way the paint interacts with it, and also the impasto depth. So if you don't like a very heavy impasto, you can turn it down. I play with these settings throughout the entire painting process. I love being able to add watercolors over a heavy impasto. The paint runs over and in between all of the cracks and lines. Lends for some very beautiful textures. Another thing I'd like to point out is a little tab over here. This will allow you to change the opacity of your watercolors from transparent to fully opaque. Side note, you can only use it if your pigment button is disabled. Hope you found this useful, and let's jump into a time lapse where I utilize all of these techniques that I just showed.